So my name is Emilien Macchi. Of course, I work for Red Hat. I have been involved in the OpenStack project for 5 years and a half. But since the beginning, I have been very focused on the deployments of OpenStack. Most of my work over the last year have been on automating the deployments of OpenStack for production environments. And I have been involved in Puppet OpenStack modules projects, where I've been the PTL for 18 months. And over the last months, I've been very involved in TripleO, and I'm currently the PTL for the last 8 months, and currently working hard on delivering TripleO to deploy OpenStack in production. Yes, and I'm also part of the OpenStack technical committee, where I have a chair when I'm involved in making sure that OpenStack can be make the right technical decision for the best operator experience. I'm trying to work on this side, making sure that we can deploy. We can take the right choice to deploy OpenStack on production. And I think that's it. Yeah, I also live in Canada. I'm French. I live in Canada, and I enjoy living there and traveling around in Quebec. So, yeah, that's it.
So Ocata has been a very short cycle.
Yeah, very short.
What were you able to accomplish? In this release?
It was very short. I think it was.
About 4 months.
Yes, so we had a very short cycle, but we still accomplished a lot of things. I think one of the biggest things is that we were able to implement a new framework for upgrades. That was, I think, one of the most exciting features we did, the composable upgrades. So let's say you want to deploy TripleO. And you have some custom roles, and you want to make sure that you can upgrade each role. We have this framework in place where you can define the configuration for each service, and we now have the framework to define how you want to upgrade the service. It's driven by Ansible, so we are also converging to Ansible more than before. And so that was one of the big things.
I've been doing several interviews today, and several people have said those same things for different projects. Mm-hmm. Is that something that is directed by the TC down, or just all the projects happen to come to the same conclusion?
So which conclusion exactly?
Focusing on composable upgrades.
Okay, focusing on upgrades. Yes, that's in the case of TripleO, that doesn't come from TC directly. It comes from the actual needs, like everyone needs to upgrade at some point. Of course, the TC is highly focused on upgrades. If you look at, for example, the Keystone project, they are working hard in this cycle on rolling upgrades, and many projects in OpenStack actually engage some work in changing the workflow for upgrading the APIs and all the services that they are developing and providing to the users. In other words, it doesn't come directly from the TC, but it comes from the actual needs. And yeah, we are going to the same direction, like making the upgrades, easier to do, safer and faster, I guess, and also in a way that anyone can easily understand how we do and easily contribute, because we are using Ansible playbooks, we think that in the future it will be easier to get more contributors implementing the upgrade workflow instead of doing it with another tool that nobody really knows. So yeah, that's one of the big things in Ocata. We also implemented many new drivers supporting TripleO, because we have some collaboration with many storage and networking vendors in OpenStack, which is one of the big, which is one of the big use cases in OpenStack, where you want to deploy some software, external software from OpenStack to manage your network or your storage. You want to plug, for example, Cinder to configure the plugin to use this storage. So in this cycle, TripleO was able to be integrated with many, many drivers. I don't think I have to like tell the driver because the list is long, but yes, in this cycle, we had some very nice integration. We also made very nice progress on NAV integration because there are some many use cases. We had a lot of users that need NAV services at the end, and we made a very good progress on this side also. We also, and the last big thing I would say is the composable HA architecture, because before you were only able to deploy one pacemaker server, one pacemaker cluster, which was running all the services in HA, and now you're able to break down the cluster in different clusters that work together, but you can actually scale up the number of services managed by pacemaker. So we are improving the way you're deploying HA in the way you can scale up the services run by pacemaker. So that's for scaling up the OpenStack clouds on this side. And I think that's it for the big feature we have to do.
Looking towards Pike, what kinds of things do you think we'll see there?
That's what we are going to figure out this week. But I can already tell that the big thing is containers. We are moving forward with deploying OpenStack on containers. We already engaged a lot of work. We actually have a world dedicated team working on this integration. They have been working on this thing for, I don't know, more than 1 year, I guess. But this is going to be very serious in Pike, because we are going to switch the services to be deployed in containers, and probably by default. So we have to figure out how to make this transition upgrade. You can call it how you want, but we need to work on how we can migrate from non-container to containerized deployment. So that's something we are working on. But that's a big thing. We also work on we are also working on features like DPDK. We are making good progress on DPDK integration for NAV. We are still doing good progress on NAV. We are also continuing the work on security management. I don't remember all the features for security, but we have a bunch of new things coming up for security. One of the big things is TLS everywhere. We already engaged most of the work in Ocata, but unfortunately we didn't have time to finish and make it stable and test it in CI, so we expect it to be like finished by the Pike cycle. So you would be able to deploy TripleO with all the endpoints in SSL from end to end, and also MySQL and RabbitMQ and all the services using SSL everywhere. So that means that TripleO will be more secure in the future. We are working also with the security team to improve the way we configure the services, doing some audit and improve, always improving the security in TripleO, because it's very important. So, I think that's the big things coming up for the next cycle.
Tell me what you think about the impact of TripleO on the overall OpenStack ecosystem.
So, if you look at OpenStack, there is a interesting diversity in the way you can install and deploy OpenStack. We have seen different kind of installers. And Red Hat is actually contributing to TripleO over the last years. And one very interesting thing with TripleO recently is that we are, and thanks to RDO, by the way, we are able to deploy TripleO from very recent packages in RDO. And because of the amazing work from RDO team, we are able to test the new features in OpenStack. And so that's called continuous delivery. We are doing continuous delivery right now. Because if you submit a patch in TripleO, you will basically run a bunch of CI jobs that will deploy OpenStack from trunk. And there is no other project in OpenStack. There is no other installer in OpenStack that can do it again. So I think there is a value here for OpenStack because in many times this year we have seen that TripleO CI was able to report some very interesting feedback to the project. So because they only rely on DevStack, which is good, but this is not for production, right? So because TripleO was here, we could give a very short feedback, in a very short time we could give some feedback and some very valuable feedback on how the things work outside DevStack. And because TripleO set up OpenStack with complex architectures, complex networking, and some projects don't have this testing coverage, right? So TripleO projects was able over the life cycle, especially in Ocata, we had given some very interesting feedback to projects like Nova and other projects in OpenStack, where we were able to say, for example, hey, this patch in Nova broke TripleO CI. And it was basically the day after, or even sometimes a few hours after that, we were very responsive to what's happening upstream on master. And thanks to that, we were able to also fix very quickly upstream what's going on. That's something other projects in OpenStack cannot do it very easily because they don't run on master, right? So that CI/CD thing was very valuable for OpenStack because it reduced the feedback loop between the developers and the people who actually deploy OpenStack. So that thing was very valuable for OpenStack. And in the future, we want to expand the TripleO CI jobs to OpenStack community. So it will be, I mean, it comes for free. If you create a new project in OpenStack and if you deploy this project in TripleO, because we have this production architecture, we can for free give you the feedback of how your project works outside classic DevStack jobs, which is again good, but not enough in my opinion to stamp that your project can be deployed in production. So yeah, I think TripleO brings very good feedback in general in OpenStack, and I hope it will continue that way. It's just a matter of collaboration between folks developing features in OpenStack versus folks actually deploying the features on the field. It's a matter of collaboration between people who build packages in RDO and make the whole production chain working between upstream, downstream, and projects like TripleO. So it's a matter of collaboration here, and my hope is that we will continue to keep reducing this feedback loop between the project and making sure that everyone understands why we are doing that. It's not about like increasing the complexity of testing, it's about reducing the feedback loop between the teams. And, you know, I think that's good for everyone here. So because we want OpenStack working in production, we need these tools. So yeah, I think that's a long-term roadmap to keep TripleO the reference today in OpenStack if you want to deploy in production. And for that, we rely a lot on the CI work, I guess. and all the pipelines with RDO. So yeah, we need to continue that way and keep progressing on the workflow and yeah.
Something that I hear from end users at events quite frequently is complaints that there are so many different ways to install and deploy OpenStack. Do you think that over time these are going to converge, or is there a benefit to having the multiple ways?
So, I think, so that's a good question, and that's exactly what is happening in OpenStack. If you look at the big tent 1 year and a half ago, actually 2 years ago almost, when we decided to go with the big tent, we accepted many projects in OpenStack, and including Puppet OpenStack modules, including TripleO, including Chef, including Ansible, and all the projects that have a lot of overlap, right? Because they all do some kind of deployments. We accepted that because we accepted that OpenStack is a unique place where you can have so much diversity. You can bring innovation. You can bring your own ID, and we trust you to be to collaborate with the community to make like OpenStack better, right? So, what we have seen over the last years, though, is that yes, we accepted many projects in OpenStack, but with the time, companies invest in something else, or people change focus, or some technology wins, some of them lose. That's the technology, that's how I think how it works, it's the market. So what I mean is that I think over the last years, that's going to continue, we will have some consolidation on the technology. So right now, we are using this tool to do this action, but because another team is doing something else, is using another tool, maybe we will converge at some point to use the same tool. So it's just a matter of like giving time to the community to figure out what's best, what technology is the best, and maybe we will eventually reduce the number of projects to deploy OpenStack. I think it's just a matter of time. I'm actually almost sure it's a matter of time. We need more consolidation. If you look at TripleO, for example, we are using a bunch of different tools to deploy different bits in TripleO. We are using Heat, Mistral, Ansible, Puppet. That sounds complex to hear, but it has a lot of history behind it. So yeah, that's the future will tell us which technology we will use, and obviously we will have some consolidation and reduce the complexity of, you know, the number of tools we are using. And generally in OpenStack, if you look at what's happening now, there is a lot of move in containers work, right? So I guess we will collaborate with OpenStack community and we are already collaborating. For example, in TripleO, we are collaborating with the Cola community, and we are using the Cola images in TripleO, so we can use the same containers. So that's kind of thing is going to increase in the future. So you will see some consolidation between the projects.
All right. Well, thank you.
Thank you.